Norman Abbott and Marjorie Creasy met and married in London in 1937. My dad, Mike Abbott, was born a Gemini the next year on June 4th, 1938. In 1939, Grandpa went off to war and Dad's life changed. Escaping the bombing in London, he was raised during the early years by his mom and grandparents in Sevenoaks, Kent. Uncle John, Dad's brother, was born 3 years after. Dad remembered the years he spent in Kent as the happiest of his childhood. When Granddad returned home from the war, the family eventually settled in an upstairs apartment on Springbank Road in Lewisham. At 15, Dad left school. His first job was a gopher on Fleet Street. He was a beach photographer for a while in the Channel Islands, and he even drove a minicab for a short time. In 1954, at 16, unhappy at home and looking for a way out, Dad joined the Merchant Navy and he went to sea. Dad loved those years and it began a love of the water that endured for the rest of his life. Over the next 6 years seeing the world, he worked his way up from galley boy to first class waiter. Dad docked in Montreal in 1958 and loved the lifestyle so much, it helped him make his decision to emigrate to Canada in the 60s. Dad and my mom, Megan, first met in London in 1962, working at a graphic design company. She was a secretary to the boss, and Dad ran their small printing press and drove the company van. They became close friends during this time in London. Dad emigrated to Toronto, Canada in 1963, and he worked as a catalog photographer. Mom returned home to Toronto, and they continued their strong friendship. Mom and Dad got together, they never stopped talking, and during that year in Toronto, it turned into a love affair. Dad hated the cold in Toronto and decided to move to warmer Vancouver. Some of his friends from London had arrived ahead of him, and they all rented a house together in the West End, nicknamed Lime House, famous for its crazed parties. A couple of months after his arrival, Dad hit the ground running and launched his entrepreneurial side with Abbott and Tinkham, a black and white photo processing service with his childhood friend John Tinkham. It was used for custom work by professional and amateur local photographers and became a social hub. Mom joined Dad in Vancouver, and in July 1967, they were married. Mom helped fund the household during the lean years, working as a legal secretary. Eventually, the company paid $11,000 for a two-story building on 4th Avenue. The street was kind of known as Vancouver's Haight-Ashbury, and Dad became a hippie. Dad's renovation side was born then, and he and Mom moved into the upstairs apartment, surrounded by rubble. Dad built a great apartment, but in 2 years living there, Mom says they never had a night alone. In 1970, Dad sold his share of Abbott and Tinkham to John. He bought a couple of residential properties in Vancouver and rented them out. In those days, dropping out was normal, and Mom and Dad drove back to Toronto to live. Dad drove a cab there and Mom worked as a legal secretary. Mom says this was Dad's wilderness year. He just wasn't happy there, and they went back to Vancouver in 1971. Learning that Mom was pregnant and they would have to support a family, Dad came up with a novel business idea. Using the last $3,000 they had left, he started Buy and Sell Press, a free classified ad newspaper. They took a big chance, but within 2 years, they went from being so broke they traded groceries for newspapers to being successful. Buy and Sell was known as a great place to work. It was also a lot of fun. Dad and his employees worked really hard, and they also played really hard. The parties and constant social gatherings became legend over the years. As Dad's business expanded, so did our family. I, Jamie, their very cute only son, was born on June 4th, 1972, which crazily is Dad's birthday as well. Uncle John arrived from London, as well as Mom's sister Auntie Kelly from Montreal, to help with the business. In 1978, Dad expanded and bought the West Ender, a community newspaper, and sold it a couple of years later for a profit. Buy and sell was my dad's passion for almost 30 years, and his nutty idea spawned hundreds of similar papers across the world. He loved that business, and Dad especially loved the people who worked for him. He thought of them as family, always recognizing their hard work to make the paper a success. He sold the buy and sell and retired in the year 2000. Dad's final big business success was Havana Restaurant on Commercial Drive. Originally started by Dad, Ken Conker, June Bennett, and two young partners. The first couple of years proved difficult, but with help from a restaurant consultant, the tables turned and profits started to come in. June stepped in and worked really hard to make it successful. Dad loved the place. If Dad was grumpy, as he was known to sometimes be, Mom would lightly suggest in her own way that he go to Havana. He always came back in a better mood. In 2017, the partners sold Havana and the building. Over the years, the family has grown. Uncle John married and now has a family of two stepdaughters and five grandkids. Auntie Kelly has two boys and a stepdaughter and three grandkids. Mom took in two of my Aunt Maureen's kids after she died and looked out for the other four over the years. Richie ended up being sales manager buy and sell in later years, and he and his sister Jessica both had kids, Cara and Sarah, who were regarded as grandkids by Mom and Dad. I have a stepdaughter, Lucy, who I consider my daughter. And Maya Tinkham was added to the family after her parents died at a young age. In the end, the party list just for family, apart from friends, could be in the 30s. Dad loved having a big family, and they gave him great joy over his life. In 2009, Mom, Richie, and I bought a communal vacation home in Palm Desert, California. Since retiring, Dad had refused to travel anywhere except on his boat with his friends around the Gulf Islands. He became curious about the house, though, and went to take a look, despite not being on a plane in 10 years. He fell in love with the place, and especially the sunny weather. Mom and Dad bought a condo and then a Spanish house in the old section of Palm Springs. It was their Shangri-La for 6 months every year. They made friends and were often surrounded by family there, and Dad became contented. From then on, whether in Palm Springs or Vancouver, and he showed his happy side, we would all call him Palm Springs Mike. Mom, Dad, and I left there 10 days before he died to go back to Vancouver so he could be in his home with his family and friends near him. On Dad's last day, he was surrounded by close family and a few friends. The weather gave him one last gift to be warmed by the sun, which he loved so much throughout his life. Later, we took Dad upstairs and we put him in bed, and everyone came in and said goodbye one last time. Mom, Richie, and I held his hands and told Dad we loved him as he peacefully closed his eyes for the last time. Dad was 80 years old and had a full, crazy, amazing life. We miss him terribly, and he will forever be in our hearts.